The college town of Madison, Wisconsin, is not the sort of place that leaps to mind when it comes to the discussion of racial disparities. But the gap between black and white residents in Madison's Dane County are, according to recent reports, more extreme than most other jurisdictions in the nation. Now, there's a new effort to find ways to bridge that gap. Hari Sreenivasan reports.
Doggone it, this is our this is our community, and we're not going to let it go to hell in a handbasket. So thank you for coming.
At the Fountain of Life Covenant Church in Madison, Wisconsin, the Reverend Alex G. recently addressed hundreds of residents about a campaign he calls Justified Anger.
Don't let our anger frustrate you. Don't let it cause you fear, consternation.
The Reverend is angry about statistics that show significant gaps between Wisconsin's white and black populations.
Racial disparity is awful. We are ground zero for so many issues, particularly those concerning African-American men.
650 people poured in. They filled this place. There was standing room only. We had 150 people in the foyer.
In a report that detailed nationwide racial disparities, the NEE Casey Foundation found Wisconsin had the worst rankings for African-American children in the country. The report cites stark differences in between African-American and white children when it comes to education, family income, and home stability.
People don't come to Madison so their kids can fail in school. People don't come to Madison so their kids can go to prison and rot in cells. Dreamers come to Madison, and when they feel excluded from the dream, they become nightmares.
G says the national spotlight on Wisconsin's racial disconnect hit a nerve.
I did the same thing 30 years ago, where we're right back again for the same issue. And I'm sick and tired of this.
Noble Ray is the interim president of the Urban League of Greater Madison.
It reflects on our community in a very deep way. What are our values? Do we believe that this is the way that there should be almost these two cities coexisting or two counties coexisting in terms of the experience that people have here in Madison and Dane County?
The reasons that cause these differences between white and black children start young, even before school.
Do you want to read that with Mama?
To get kids caught up before entering school, Dane County officials began sending social workers to work with parents from underserved communities. Katie Snow is the program supervisor.
The brain is developing very rapidly in the first 3 years of life, and particularly in that first year. So you want as much as possible to have a stable family situation where there's not a lot of stress.
Joe Parisi, executive for Dane County, says the program is specifically designed to close the educational gap.
We engage the parents and the kids in opportunities to learn how to interact with each other in the most productive way, and aimed at helping those kids achieve the educational and developmental milestones necessary to enter four-year-old kindergarten at the same level as the majority of the kids coming in.
Twist! Twist! Can you twist?
Dion Bluen says working with Snow has helped her improve her daughter's language and comprehension.
And I feel like being a young mom, you just feel like you're going wrong with a lot of things, and you just need that support to let you know you're doing good and what to do, what not to do. And I think that's very important.
Okay, we'll come back to you, Ashanti.
By the time babies like Dion's are in middle school, the gaps are significant.
Who can remind us what that meant?
In Wisconsin middle schools, white children are 6 times more likely to be proficient in 8th grade math than black students. Reading proficiencies for African-American students are 4 times worse. Principal Tremaine Clarity from Senate Middle School welcomes attention to the problem.
There are definitely disparities that we have to address and are addressing.
Clarity, who wrote his doctoral dissertation on racial disparities, says educators need to make learning more personal and purposeful.
When a student identifies a purpose for being in a classroom and you enhance that with culturally relevant curriculum, that's when the light comes on. That's when the education truly happens.
Ray links much of the racial divide to poverty and employment opportunities.
The gap is pretty striking. For African Americans, it's 25% unemployment here in Dane County. For whites, it's 4.8% unemployment. So that's pretty stark.
Those unemployment numbers are troubling at a time when Madison's construction industry is experiencing a labor shortage. So the Urban League partnered with Dane County officials to train minorities for trade industry jobs. They helped Walter Konya, who had trouble finding work after high school.
I believe that the odds are stacked against you as a minority,
you know, within the state and the country. But programs like this do help even the odds in a great way, I'd say.
Call DJ!
What Madison is facing is not unlike racial disparities seen across the country. The Annie E. Casey report called the imbalance between African American and white children's achievement a national crisis. Community leaders see it as a call to action.
If we don't capture it now, if we don't address it now, then I'm really concerned about what Madison will become in the next decade.
And so what is the solution for Madison?
I think what's going to be different is the indigenous voice. We're rarely at the table. We're rarely asked what we think. And that doesn't dignify us. So we're the topic of every discussion. We're the subject of every report. And we don't get to interject. We don't get to submit. We don't get to say anything.
Noble Ray says that may be changing.
There seems to be a movement. There's community leaders. There are nonprofits involved. There are grassroots people that are talking about this. All of the other initiatives were really led by government. And that has been one of the problems, because we can never sustain the effort. Politically, when we get turnover, it's not thought about anymore.
We have the wherewithal and we have the goods. The question is, do we have the will to change this on our watch?
Both Reverend G and Noble Ray are optimistic that addressing the thorny issue of racial disparity here in Wisconsin could become a template for other communities around the country.